Very grateful to both the Maharajas for setting the right mood in which this Bhagavatam learning should be done at the outset itself. So, as Maharaj was also saying, that we are not here to become Shushka Gyanis, just, you know, loading with lot of knowledge, but rather gain the knowledge of Bhagavatam and scriptures to transform our lives, you know, in our own practice of Krishna consciousness and also help others. So as it is said, Vidya Bhagavata Vadhi or Vidyavatam Bhagavate Pariksha, right? Person's learning is tested when it comes to Bhagavatam actually. Bhagavatam is the summit of the highest summit of the knowledge. So that's how the main focus in our school is the knowledge of Srimad Bhagavatam, you know, which will be taught for 4 semesters. And then along with that, additional whatever is complementary for studying Bhagavatam, whatever is needed and it can act as a supplement for Srimad Bhagavatam study, that's also you know, provided in this entire curriculum. So we have 6 semesters in the 3 years program, and within these 3 years the plan is to offer Bhakti Vaibhav, Bhakti Vedant as well as Bhakti Sarobhavan degrees. So 6 semesters of each, 5 months each, you know, there is 1 month vacation in each semester, and 5 months is every semester. So in this 4 semester we study Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Prabhupada's translation and purports of Srimad Bhagavatam. 4 semesters the study is continued, a detailed study verse by verse and Prabhupada's Bhaktivedanta purports, primarily focusing on that. And this is done for 4 semesters from 1 to 4. Along with that, in the first semester, Sambhashan is introduced, Sanskrit Sambhashanam, because just to give a taste of Sanskrit language, it's very important that some Sambhashanam can be done. And it's there for semester 1, where we will learn Sambhashanam from Sanskrit Bharati experts. There is an institution called Sanskrit Bharati, which is, you know, India's one of the best institutions to teach spoken Sanskrit, you know, or Sambhashanam, what we are calling. So the one of the teachers from there would come and teach, you know, Sambhashanam, Sanskrit, spoken Sanskrit in the first semester. From there, all 4 semesters we have the same schedule, and that's Srimad Bhagavatam purports, along with that Sandarbhas, then we have Sanskrit grammar and Shad Darshan. So this is the same schedule will be followed for all 4 semesters. We have Srimad Bhagavatam classes, then we will be studying Sandarbhas one after another. In 6 semesters we would finish 6 Sandarbhas, right from Tattva Sandarbh to Priti Sandarbh. We have grammar being taught, which is sutra based, you know, and based on the feedback and how students are faring, you know, we will also see whether we have to tweak in the challenge, in the style of teaching grammar. And there is also Shad Darshan, so in which only the brief outline of a particular system will be taught. We are not going to get into very technical details of Nyaya and Mimamsa and Vedanta. But whatever is needed, that is needed for our Bhagavatam commentary study, because oftentimes Srila Jiva Goswami quotes something from Nyaya or something from Vedanta, and if we don't know those concepts, it's difficult to get the right import of that particular tika or that particular statement which is made by Acharya. So only that much is needed. It's a brief overview of Nyaya system, Mimamsa system, Vedanta and Sankhya and all that, you know, that would be done. So this would continue from semester 1 to 4, you know, these 4 things, Srimad Bhagavatam, Shat Sandarbhas, grammar and Darshan. Only addition is in first semester Sambhashanam, spoken Sanskrit. So that's how 4 semesters would go. Then in 5th semester we would introduce Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, you know, along with Prabhupada purports. And also we will introduce Sri Govinda Bhashya, which is Vedanta Sutra's commentary by Baldev Vidya Bhushan. So some concepts of Govinda Bhashya would be introduced in the 5th semester, along with Chaitanya Charitamrita, complete entire Chaitanya Charitamrita, while Sandarbhas and grammar, you know, those things go on like that. In last semester, there is Acharya commentaries would be introduced on Srimad Bhagavatam We would have Acharya commentaries like Sridhar Swami's commentary, Srila Jiva Goswami's, then Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's commentaries. So because this is only one semester, so obviously we can't cover end to end, but an entry would be made into. An entry into reading commentaries, how are those commentaries read, you know, what is the style of commentaries that would be taught, so that because already the grammar knowledge is there, the students would be able to themselves read and understand the commentaries and, you know, make a sense of what's being spoken by acharyas over there. Also, in the last semester, there would be some knowledge of kavya, poetry in Sanskrit. So Kavya Prakash or Sahitya Darpan, one of the granthas will be taught. Sahitya Darpan is by Baldev Vidyabhushan, while Kavya Prakash is a standard treatise on Sanskrit, you know, poetry, that's recommended even by Lord Chaitanya. So we would decide and teach, you know, some part of this, so that people get an idea of Sanskrit poetry and how this is studied. And also Govinda Bhashya, the concepts would be continued like that. So that's the basic program. I'll also put this up on the notice board so that you can see it in detailed manner, what is there in every semester. But to summarize, that's all the program is. Four semesters we study Srimad Bhagavatam, fifth semester we study Chaitanya Charitamrita, and then sixth semester we study Tikas of Acharyas, like that. That's the program, along with the other things like Sandarbha and Darshan and all that. So attempt is to equip devotees with sufficient Sanskrit knowledge so that they gain an entry in the Tikas and as well as, you know, in the root text of Srimad Bhagavatam and all the scriptures, you know. Because when we say about tradition, we should teach traditionally, you know, in the traditional manner we should teach Bhagavatam. It's very important, as Prabhuji also spoke, that the knowledge of Sanskrit is there and the knowledge of root text is there, that how the root text is you know, interpreted, what is the way to understand the words, and you do the anvaya. Anvaya is, you know, logical arrangement of the entire shloka. So a typical traditional way enlists five characteristics of a discourse or of an essay, of a presentation, and that's called as padacheda padarthokti vigraho vakya yojana akshepasya samadhanam shadvidham panchalakshanam vyakhyanam. It is said vyakhyanam panchalakshanam. These are the five lakshanas or symptoms of a vyakhyan, of a discourse, of an essay. So what is that padached? You know, you separate the padas, then give the meaning, and then you give vigraha, how they combine together to form a logical sentence. Then you give vakya yojana, and then in the end you also answer any objection. So actually it's amazing, Prabhupada already follows this style in his purports, you know. Although specifically it is not mentioned, but Prabhupada, you know, usually in his purports he follows this style very perfectly well. So this would be taken in a typical traditional way, like we do for the verses and all that in Sanskrit. So that's the plan for six semesters. Now for this semester, I would also just like to let you know the teachers who are for semester one, especially Bhagavatam teaching, the purports of Bhagavatam. So that would be taught by, you know, great teachers like His Holiness Bhakti Dhir Damodar Swami Maharaj. For this semester, we have His Grace Kamal Lochan Prabhu, Hari Lila Prabhu, Gauranga Darshan Prabhu, Balram Shakti Prabhu, Venu Gopal Prabhu, and Kanai Krishna Das for teaching the Bhagavatam purports for this particular semester. So other semesters, you know, schedules and all will be displayed later. About daily schedule, we have 6 days classes in a week. We have Sunday off, and like this 5 months in a semester. Okay, so daily schedule would be like this. You know, we have gathering. We'll begin the classes at 10 o'clock. This is post prasad. 9 o'clock we have prasadam, morning prasad, and then 10 o'clock we will assemble for first session, which is 2 hours, which is Srimad Bhagavatam, Prabhupada purports, you know, Bhagavatam along with Prabhupada purports. That's the first class, 10 to 12, 2 hours. Then we have a 15 minutes break, and 12:15 to 1:15 would be Sanskrit Sambhashanam, spoken Sanskrit, you know, 1 hour. So that's quite an interesting and enlivening session, you know, which with a lot of fun. So then we have 1:15 to 2:15 as a break. You know, this is a break in which, you know, devotees can do their individual things. And 2:15 again we'll assemble, and 2:15 to 4 p.m. will be Sanskrit Vyakaran. You know, so this will also involve teaching of concepts of Vyakaran and then some interactive session to see the learning. And this is how 4 o'clock we end. So this is the first semester schedule. From 10 to 4 we have the entire teaching being done. Primarily it's Srimad Bhagavatam, Prabhupada purports, then Sanskrit Sambhashanam and Sanskrit Vyakaran. You know, so this would go on for next 2 months, that is July and September. And in September, July and August, and in September we will introduce the Sandarbhas as well as Shad Darshanas. That's the, you know, way. By that time Sanskrit grammatical concepts would be over. So that's the brief schedule, you know, brief or rather elaborate schedule of our program. And this will be also put up on the notice board. So any of you want to take a look at it, please take a look like that. So we really seek blessings of, it's a power, it's a knowledge packed program, so to say. So many things are there in the, you know, 3 years to study. So we really look forward to students that they put their best effort, and we also seek blessings of great devotees, you know, Maharajas and all the assembled devotees over here, that we can put in best effort in terms of teaching as well as learning, so that actually we take this knowledge with us, not just to become a big jnani, as Maharaj also said, but indeed become a devotional scholar. You know, as Jiva Goswami also says, shushka jnana is very much discouraged, but bhajaniya tattva sambandhi jnana, he says, is very much recommended. Tatpadartha jnana, that is Ishwar jnana, and tvam padartha jnana, that is knowledge of Jiva's swarupa, it's very much recommended, he says. It goes a long way in a devotee's life. So that bhajaniya tattva sambandhi jnana is to be gained, and by that our bhajan is to be improved. That's the purpose over here, like that. So thank you so much. Hare Krishna.